Hello, my name's Ryan, and I'm here to show you how the Cavitette system is inspected in Hamilton County. Again, we begin with the lids and risers, same as all other systems. Looking for intact, proper seal, ensure that no safety hazards or cases where there may be excess runoff are able to make it into the lid. Also note the clearance of the riser to the ground, high enough to prevent any runoff from getting inside the system, rather being diverted away from the system. Note that both lids, the primary aerator lid and the clarifier lid, are intact, devoid of cracks, and are sized appropriate for the access openings. Moving inside the system, we look at the risers, inspect those for proper integrity. In this particular system, they're made out of concrete and brick. Many different materials are acceptable. But again, looking for proper seal, ensure there is no shifting, and ensure that the materials themselves are not cracked or damaged, presenting a safety hazard to the system or a problem with treatment. Moving inside the Cavitette unit, we come to the aeration chamber, which is the point where all waste and water from the house enters the system. This is a converted unit, as evidenced by the replacement of the original belt-driven motor by this rotary vane motor. This motor pumps oxygen to multiple points, which all include treatment of the effluent. We check the intake of the motor to make sure that the air filter is clean and is allowing air to move properly in and then down to the proper points on the system. Notice that this air filter has a slight buildup of dirt. We might recommend that this air filter be replaced by the next annual inspection or during the next routine service. We also check to see that the motor is properly wired up. In many cases, these motors are controlled by timers inside the home. In cases where the timer is inside the home and the Cavitette may not be running during the time of inspection, we must check the temperature of the motor. A warm motor indicates that it has been running cycles. We do this either by touch of the exterior motor itself or by measure of an infrared thermometer gun. We compare this temperature with the temperature of the surrounding wall. Moving to the air line, we see that the air line is properly clamped to the output of the motor. This will ensure that as the motor cycles on and off, the connection, though it may vibrate and shake, is not loosed and falls off, which would prevent proper treatment. Where the air line is divided to the two treatment components, the primary diffuser, the larger line, and the return line, the smaller line. The primary diffuser goes into the water, forms a cross with holes drilled in it, and as the motor runs, pumps air into the system. This helps to circulate the waste and feed oxygen to bacteria, which will treat and break down the solid material. The return line, again the smaller line, feeds air directly to the bottom of the tank. The discharge point for the return line is the one that appears to be coming up out of the water. This line actually goes to the bottom of the tank, is angled toward the clarifier, and is designed to pick waste off the bottom of the tank, returning it to the top for continued treatment and circulation. Note that the air lines for both the primary diffuser, the return line, and the discharge for the return line are properly anchored to the tank top. As they receive pressure, these lines may move. These anchors prevent any sort of oscillation and or damage to the lines that may result from movement. When examining the primary aeration chamber of the Cavitette unit, we look for certain signs that may indicate defects with treatment and or the proper operation of the system. The surface of the water, for instance, should be mostly smooth. If there are bubbles or a buildup of solid matter, this may indicate that the diffuser is not receiving air or that the motor is not operating properly. We also examine to see if there's any sort of odor. If no odor is detected, that usually indicates that the system is treating properly. When the motor is running, you will see aeration and oscillation, turbulence in the water, a lot of bubbling, and a lot of movement. You will also see discharge from the return line nozzle just above the surface of the water over here. After moving from the aeration compartment, we move to the clarifier compartment of the Cavitette system. The Cavitette has the clarifier, which is the smaller half of the tank. This portion of the tank comes straight down and then angles back toward the aeration side. If we look down in, we'll note intact riser walls all the way down, and we will see a buildup of scum. This is normal. The clarifier is the last chance that solid waste has to settle out of a Cavitette system. The scum itself has no way to be returned from this compartment to the main chamber for continued treatment. The return line, which we examined earlier, sucks waste off the bottom of this compartment. The reason for the tank being angled is so that any heavy material will slide back and be angled toward the return line, making it easier to retrieve. We're looking to ensure that there is no movement of air or water in this compartment. If there would be, it might indicate that there's an issue with the return line or that the crossover pipe, which allows water to move from the primary chamber to the clarifying chamber, has developed some sort of clog. Looking further in, if visible, we check for the outlet baffle. In this tank, is toward this side in the corner. If visible, it's usually composed of one of two materials, either originally concrete, forming a square structure, or PVC, forming a circular structure. Looking to see inside that baffle, we want to make sure that only water, which has been treated, is leaving the tank, and that all solid material is being left behind. Now we come to the discharge point of the sewage treatment system. Sewage treatment systems discharge to many different types of points, but they should be well maintained regardless of the area. Note here, if the discharge pipe is elevated and is clear of any obstructions, debris, and also includes an animal guard, these two screws through the pipe, to help prevent any solid buildup at the outlet. Solid buildup at the outlet pipe or debris anywhere close may result in backup, which could damage or hinder treatment in the tank. At the discharge point, we try to examine the effluent leaving the system. This should be treated effluent, indicated by clear, odorless discharge. Discharge that is gray, blackish, or has an odor may indicate that the system is not treating as designed or may have some sort of fault. Note here, there's not a lot of discharge leaving right this moment, barely a trickle. This indicates that there's minimal use inside the home. In times of activity or heavier use on the water supply, you will notice a more steady stream leaving the pipe. Again, even in times of increased activity, this should be clear and odorless. This discharge pipe is made of Schedule 40 PVC. Modern systems and replacement pipes should all be Schedule 40 PVC. Some discharge pipes that are original to the home may be made of clay or other materials, but please be ensured that no matter what the material, it is kept free of debris and is operating properly, carrying effluent to the designated discharge point.